You guys all gonna do that? Let me hear it. Yes!
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 Yes! Yeah, keep those muscles strong. Maybe I'll ask the MPF if we could do a wall class, because I think that would be good. You know, just one special just to show it to you guys. Just make sure you all situate yourself near a wall. All right, any other comments before we get going? All right, we will start then.
Okay, and
what'd you say? I don't know what I heard. Okay, we'll just get going. You can always unmute yourself if you want to say something.
That was me. I just said I was muting everyone.
Oh, okay. Yep. I'm just making sure.
Yeah.
So find a nice seat in your chair. Maybe rock forward and back to find the center of your sitting bones. And hear the creak of the chair. As you rock forward, you'll feel the weight go into your feet. And as you rock back, you'll feel the weight lessen in your feet, maybe move a little bit more towards the back of your hips. You'll also feel a difference in your belly. So if we rock forward, the belly may release any toning. As we lean back, it's almost like instinct. It turns on, the core turns on. So we lift tall. Lift up and out of the waist. In fact, take your hands, your fingers, your pointer finger and your thumb, and put it at the crest of your hip and the bottom of your rib cage so you can feel that. Now, go ahead and make a like a roll forward, shoulders forward, kind of like cat, or sometimes when we're gravity's pulling us forward, and notice how the front of the body shortens. Then lift up tall, draw the shoulders up and back, and feel how this got longer. Then push down through your feet and your sitting bones and thighs on the chair, and notice how this area gets even longer. Now keep all that. Relax your arms down by your side. Take a breath in and a breath out. And let's inhale, arms forward, out to the side and wide, spreading fingers. Let's do Popeye, because you guys are so strong, we're talking about muscles. Bring your thumbs on the inside of the palms, wrap your fingers around, give your thumb a big old hug, and then become Popeye. Pull your knuckles in towards your shoulders. Try not to tighten anything else besides your arm muscles, right? And now pull back, like with resistance. Pull the knuckles back and then open up your hands. Beautiful. Let's go for that again. Thumb on the inside, wrap fingers around, pull knuckles in towards shoulders. And check it out, because if your head or you're feeling your neck muscles get kind of tight, if they tighten and contract, go ahead and let your head rock a little bit, side to side or forward and back, very gently. Let's pull this out. So pull the knuckles outwards. Spread the fingers. Bring the arms forward, interlace fingers, press palms away. Beautiful. Pull knuckles in towards you, elbows are bending. Now push the insides of your fingers towards each other. So hands towards each other, feel your strength. Keep pressing in, but pull away and feel a widening across your forearms and your chest. Now we pull in, so push in, it's a very small movement, right? Then pull out. These are different types of movements that we can do to build strength with our own body parts. Let's open up the arms. Press the palms away, fingers upwards. So now we're flexing. Imagine that you're pressing two walls on either side of you, pressing your palms into it. Now pull your hands in towards you and then press away once again. That's it. Pull them in towards you. You're releasing that. And now push away nice and slow. Extend through your fingers. Bring your arms forward, turn the palms upright. Nice, open it up. Lift the arms to your range of motion. They still may be not quite ready to lift all the way up to your full range. Lift up and out of your waist. Now pull your rib cage back. Stack your rib cage over your hips. Lift a little bit taller. Side bend to your right. One or both arms are up. You could be holding the chair with the inside hand as you take that side bend. Let's open it up, gaze at the fingers, take it back overhead, over your ear, stretch long. Open it up. Lift it over the ear. Press down through the left hip especially. Notice that the ribs are jutting forward. Pull them back, because that's our inner strength. We don't want to give that away. Open it up. Release the hand. Take it outside your right thigh. First twist of the day. We grow tall. We push down through our feet and our hips. And then we turn head last. Find your twist. Breathe in. And breathe out. And breath is in. And breath is out. Inhale back to center. Make that fist. I want you to imagine that you're holding on to a washcloth and it's really wet and you're going to wring it out. So one hand goes downward, knuckles go down, and then switch it up. So you're alternating, wringing out the wet washcloth. Get all the water, soapy suds out of there. Wring it out. Notice how this feels. It's a nice little wrist release. And let's circle the knuckles around, the wrists around. And release hands and lap. With your feet, your heels about under your knees, pretend that washcloth is down on the floor and curl your toe, your right toes to pick it up, dangle it, drop it, spread your toes, put it down. Up, it's down, pick it up now with the left foot, curl your toes in, the arch activates. So you can see we're building muscles we're contracting them in the foot. Pick up the washcloth, spread your fingers, it drops. Let's do that one more time each side. Curl toes under, make an arch. Lift the washcloth up. You can use your hands or without hands. Spread your toes, let it go. Curl toes under, pick up washcloth, spread it and drop the washcloth, spread the toes, release it down. We're going to do a few cat-cows thinking about our rib cage. So I'll turn to the side here. Exhale, when you round into cat pose, your rib cage is moving back. When we go towards cow pose, the rib cage moves forward, the heart lifts, the sitting bones move back. Let's do this a few times. I want you to feel what happens with the rib cage, the center. Exhale, we round, chins to chest, lean back. Inhale, we lift up, shoulder blades up, towards each other, sitting bones back. Now, feel that rib cage, how it's forward. You might even take your hands. See how that is. We don't need to give up so much of that. So come back to neutral. Pull the rib cage towards the back of your shirt. Roll on. Now find cat. It pulls back. Rib cage pulls back. Lift up. Feel the rib cage pulling back. Lift your heart. You're not quite letting the rib cage go so far forward. You might feel a stretch in your belly and cow. One more time. Exhale, round. Inhale, lift. And let's return to center. You should do those side bends on the other side. Inhale, arms lift. Reach up. Exhale, side bend towards your left. Lift up and towards the right. Beautiful. Inhale, floating side to side. Hear your breath, feel your breath. I don't know if you guys saw the newsletter the MPF sent out yesterday. Let's side bend towards the left, but we did a little breath article in there at the end. First, it talks about all the teachers from the classes. At the back or the end of the newsletter, there is an article on the breath that you can read. Let me know if you have any feedback or questions from it. Inhale, rise up, both arms reach up high. Let's exhale, take our arms out to the side. Yes, like you're floating. Now pulse your arms up towards the sky. Little pulses. That usually is building some muscle. Notice what you're feeling as we do these gentle and gentle. These little pulses. There we go. So you can feel your shoulder blades come on the back. Let's release the head and the jaw and the arms without falling forward. So tack your thighs and your hips into the chair, down into the chair, and you'll feel a little lengthening through the spine. Releasing the head and the jaw. See if you can let go of any holding that you may have in your fingers, your hands. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale, take your hands to your thighs. Push down into your thighs. Draw your shoulders up and back. Press down, rise up. When we're doing those push-ups at the wall, let's imitate it without actually being at the wall. So we're seated. Our elbows are down by our, they're lower than our shoulders. So check that out. If they're up here, notice what happens. The shoulders creep up. So bring them down so they're a little bit below. And pretend that you have a wall in front of you. You're pushing your fingertips into the wall. You're also pushing this pointer finger knuckle into the wall so your wrists don't get any ouchies or discomfort. Now, shoulders are up and back. We feel our shoulder blades on our back. Then press into the wall, the imaginary wall, as you come forward. And then inhale, rise up. So it's the resistance. We exhale. As we exhale and push into the wall, we're pushing, pushing, pushing. That's the resistance, helps us build our strength and our muscles. Now, to push away from the wall, push your palms into the wall, lift up. We really have to imagine we got that wall in front of us, right? One more time. Now, this time, let's make sure we keep the ribs back. So, ribs back, stacked over hips. Shoulder blades on the back. You can feel them. If you do a little bit of pulse with your elbows, you can feel the ribs wrapping around towards your spine. Keep all that, lean forward, keeping the ribs back, press into the wall. Press into the imaginary wall. Now, push the wall away, rise up. Let's take our arms up overhead. reach high, even the shoulders lift up, reach. Notice how the ribs might come forward, but let it go just so you can get a big stretch. Release the arms down. You guys are awesome. Let's take the right knee out to the side and the left leg forward. Adjust yourself on the chair so you don't feel like it's cutting you and your inner thighs anywhere. Check out that the heel is under the knee. Now here's more resistance to play with. Sometimes people's knees move forward like that. And sometimes knees move back like that. So we want to push down through the big toe mound across the ball in the center of the heel. We do that, that's going to help. Another way to play with resistance in your strength is to use your hand, push your hand into your inner thigh and your inner thigh into your hand. Make sure you're drawing your shoulder back. Now you're working your strength in your leg and your hands. Notice what you feel activating. So we're pushing inner thigh into hand, hand in the inner thigh, elbows back. Now release that. Notice what happens. Let's take the hand to the outside of the thigh. Push the hand into the outside of the thigh, but put the outside of the thigh, press it into the hand. That's your strength too. You want to make sure your shoulder's up and back. So it's not coming forward. It's up and it's back. It's on your back. Push. Take a breath in. And take a breath out. Inhale, inflate, expand, exhale completely. Feel the belly slightly tighten. Let's do a few stretching moments here. So inhale, arms lift up. Beautiful. Exhale, bend elbows. Tip the elbows slightly forward. Notice how that changes your shoulder blades. Take the elbows back. Notice how that changes it. Back to elbows down. Then inhale, reach up. Exhale, go slightly forward, but keep your hand on your leg so the knee doesn't go forward. Maybe hands at your hips. Shoulders up and back. Inhale, rise up. Drag the front heel back underneath your knee, hands on your thighs. Lean now again, shoulders up and back, elbows bending back by your side. We're going to do a few push-ups here. Are you right? You ready? So shoulders are up and back, rib cage is back, exhale, lowering, palms are pressing into thighs. Now push palms into thighs to rise up. Angle your sit bones down towards the chair. That was fun. Let's do it a few more times. Shoulders up and back, ribs back. Press hands into thighs. Feel the resistance as you push your palms into your thighs. Press down, rise up, shoulders up and back. You guys loving this? Yes? One more. So we can take yoga push-ups in so many different ways. Lean forward. Spine is long. Rib cage is back. Elbows are back. Feel the weight in your feet. Lengthen through your spine. Now, let's let the arm bones kind of travel down the leg. Press your arms into your legs. Legs into arms. Breathe in. And breathe out. Press down through your feet. Inhale, rise up. Arms lift. Exhale, hands at the heart. Bring your right foot back to front. Let's inhale, lift the heels. Exhale, lower them down. Inhale, they rise up. Exhale, they lower. One more time. Inhale, they lift up. Take your arms forward. Interlace your fingers. Press your palms away. Heels are rising, arms are rising. Exhale, lower heels and arms. Let that go. Open up the left knee to the side. Heels under knee. Right leg is forward. Make any adjustments you need to in the chair. And just notice as we breathe, do you feel like the knee might be tending to go in or out? And it may not happen quite yet, right? It might be just like as we're talking, it might start to lean one way or the other. Just like when we walk, sometimes we walk towards, we do have habit patterns. If you look at the bottom of your shoes, you can tell if you tend to walk towards the outside of the foot or the inside. You can kind of see your pattern on the bottom of your shoe. It's kind of interesting. It gives us information. Push the back of your forearm into your thigh, or you can use your hand, elbows back, shoulders on back, press hand into thigh or forearm into thigh. I like the palm forward. It really helps keep the shoulder back. So thigh's pushing into arm and arm is pushing into thigh or leg. Let's try it in the back now. Take your hand to the back, push it in, press your thigh against your hand and your hand against your thigh. Breathe in, breathe out, feel your strength. Breathe in. Exhale completely, feel the belly tone. Release and bring the heel on in. Let's do some of those push-ups on this side. Hands on thighs, shoulders up and back. Lean forward, you're gonna feel the weight come into your feet. Keep making sure your shoulders are on your back. So for me, I take my shoulders up and back and then gently pull the blades towards each other as you push down through your thighs. Press down, rise up. Come forward. You're still pushing down, right? Push down, lengthening from your tailbone out through the top of your head. Press down, rise up. Yes, one more. Lengthening spine, soles pushing down. Feel the resistance, feel the strength in your hands. Rise up. Now shake it out in case anything was getting kind of sticky or uncomfortable in your hands. Sometimes we put that pressure on when we do yoga push-ups and the hands get a little sore. So shake it out, let it go. Don't hold back. And then release, lengthen the right leg. Let's keep our hands at our hips, lean forward, shoulder blades on back. Inhale, rise up. Grow tall, lean forward. Feel maybe a little stretch here. The heel's pushing down, the knee is staying back. Rise up, bring the heel back in. And the left foot back to meet the right. And we will open up into goddess. Goddess pose. Inhale, heels rise. Exhale, they lower. Inhale, they lift up. Exhale, they lower. Take your arms out to the side. Big hug. Right arm over left. Big, 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 big hug. Feel your shoulder blades back behind you. Open it up. Exhaling other way. Hug, 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 hug. Big hug. Open it up. And release down. Okay, bring the feet back in and we will do some standing poses. If you feel like you want to sit, feel free to. I'm going to bring this phone closer because my watch battery wasn't working and I need to make sure I stay on time. And so you can stand or sit for warrior two. Before we go into warrior two, we start in mountain pose. We're back to talking about this rib cage business. So I'm gonna turn to the side. Now you can hold on to a wall or a chair for balance and take your hands back to the the fingertip to the crest of your hip, and then your lower ribs. You can feel, go ahead and push your ribs forward. We don't really want to do that, but look what happens. We lose our balance. We lose all alignment. Now pull the ribs back. Notice how the spine looks straighter. Don't look like a banana anymore. Do that one more time so you can feel it. Press the ribs forward. Doesn't feel so good. Shoulder blades can't even go onto the back here. Stresses out the neck. Pull the ribs back. Press down through the feet. Lift tall. Lift tall because you can. Tone your hips. Breathe in and breathe out. So we start in mountain pose. Then we take our feet wide. First toes are forward. Push down your feet into the earth. When you push down, you are activating the muscles on your legs. Push them down like you mean business. Rib cage is back. Now we're gonna take the right toes out. Now you might have the chair either in front of you, I'll put it in front so you can see. You can keep both hands on the chair. We're gonna lower, we're actually gonna take the knee out towards over the heel. And then feel the weight in your feet. Make sure the rib cage stays back. Inhale, lengthen the leg. Exhale, we bend. Inhale, we lengthen. So we keep the length in our body even though we're bending the knee. Exhale, bend the knee. Now, the longer we hold this, the more we are calling on our strength, right? So you don't want to take it too far, like, oh yeah, I'm fatigued, I got to come out of this. You want to come out before you're super fatigued, but go ahead, maybe touch your thigh. Notice how it's working. Push your feet down and now pull the right heel towards the left. Pull them towards each other. Pull the left towards the right. Yes. Open up maybe one arm. Gaze over your front fingertips. Breathe in and breathe out. Now take a break if you feel that you need to. If not, stay right where you're at and let's breathe for three full breaths. Breathe in, exhale completely. Breathe in, belly expands. Exhale completely, feel a toning in your belly. One more, breathe in. Breathe out through your nose, straighten your leg, all 10 toes forward, and walk your feet back towards each other. That was a while to hold that pose. When we hold it for a while, these guys, they get a little bit stronger. We have to ask them to work. Okay, we'll go for the other side. Wide stance. Wide stance. You might even soften your knees at first, right? Like do a little bouncy action here. Soften, soften, little bouncies. Then straighten the legs. Push them down like you mean business. Take an inhale. On your exhale, angle your hips down, your sitting bones down. We're tall. Turn the left foot out. Bend the knee over the heel. Warrior two, left side. Feel your left heel isometrically pull towards your right foot. And then pull your right foot towards your left. What happens is we have this energy pulling into the center, pulling into the center. That keeps us strong. Maybe take one arm out to the side, maybe both. Those are maybes. Maybe both hands stay on the chair, but let's breathe in and out fully. Tone the belly at the end of the exhale. Inhale, exhale, toning. One more, breathe in. Exhale, toning. Lengthen the leg. Turn the 10 toes forward and bring it back in. Notice how you're feeling now. Maybe walk in place a little bit here. Lifting one on the other. This is super good for you. You can hold on to or have your fingers at the wall when you do this. Lift the feet up. Lift them up. So bend the knee, lift it up. Bend the knee, lift it up. Feel your feet as they walk in place. As they lower down, feel what touches first. And then with awareness, lower the heel, ball, toe. Then other side, lift it, push down through the opposite side, lower, heel, ball, toe. Go back to a little bit faster and maybe swinging one or both arms. Exaggerate, exaggerate. You might do same arm and leg, or you could do opposite. It's a little bit of a brain teaser. You have to stop for a moment because one way is more natural than the other way. Maybe it's just one arm swinging forward and back. That's a little different, isn't it? Try it. It's a little different. Breathe in and breathe out. Okay. Take the chair, face it this way. We're back to our mountain pose. When we do these heel lifts, we want to make sure the body doesn't turn into a banana. So I'll show banana once, but that's not what we want to do. We start in our mountain, we pull the rib cage. No, I'm not gonna pull the rib cage because I want you to see the banana. So here we go. Up we go. Rib cage goes forward. Balance is gonna be off. Gonna be hard here. I don't even think I could hold my balance here. It'd be very hard. Now, pull the ribs back with heels down. Feel your mountain pose. Lift heels up, keeping ribs back. No longer a banana. Tone the hips. Tone the hips. Lift the arches. Lift the heels. Lift the ankle. Breathe in. Breathe out. Longer we hold this, building some muscles, but you come down before you get fatigued. Exhale, slowly lower down. Breathe in and breathe out. Breath is in and breath is out. Inhale, heels rise. Maybe you play with one hand coming up. You can play with the other, maybe fingertips together, maybe one arm up overhead. We're breathing, right? Finding a spot to stare at. Maybe switching arm. Maybe both arms lift, reaching high. Exhale, lower down. That was fun. Now, let's turn the toes down and kind of tap it. And so you're stretching the front of the ankle, a little bit of tapping. Then release that, step a little back, bend both knees, do it again. Little tap here, and then hold it and see if you get a nice stretch in the front of the ankle. If you cramp, step the foot down. Take a break. Doing the other side, bend the knees, step the other foot back, turn it so the top of your foot is down, your toenails are down, give it a tap. Little love taps, nothing hard. Breathe in and out, step it forward. Release that, let it go. And we will move towards horsey pose. Really, I call goddess, but I've heard it horsey, so we'll go with it. Feet are out to the side. Knees are bent. Yes. So knees are coming over heels. Notice how this could happen. The knees are coming forward, one or both. Notice how the weight is not in my feet evenly. not across the ball of the foot. So in order to help that out, I'm gonna push down through the big toe mound and across towards the pinky. And then take your awareness to the center of your heel. You can't see it anyway, it's down. Feel both center of the heels pressing down. Maybe go a little bit deeper. Now we hold this. We're working both thighs now. Breathe in. Breathe out. You might take one arm up. You might take both arms up. Remember, these are maybes. Feel the soles of your feet. Feel your hips slightly lower. Keep the knees opening wide. Press down, rise up. All 10 toes forward. Walk it on in. Notice if you are feeling any heat building. Now, let's do a wall dog. We haven't done one yet. Hands on the chair or a wall, hence why it was called wall dog. Hands on chair. We should call it chair dog. We're going for chair dog. Walk your feet back, feet parallel. Bend the knees. Lift the ribs towards the back of your shirt. It's like you're knitting them to the back of the shirt. Knees are bent, sit bones move back, get a nice lengthening through the spine. Crown of the head is angling towards the chair. Now make sure the head doesn't drop down like that. We want the head lifted so the neck is long. Crown of the head, the top of your head is got a beam of light going through the chair. Knees bent. Inhale, straightening, perhaps not straightening all the way, just till you feel a stretch, legs are working. Exhale, bending, knees bend. Now isometrically, feel like you're pulling your feet towards each other, sit bones lifting, lengthening through the back of the leg. Let's walk it in. Whew, this is a lot of work. Who brought up this idea of building muscles and strength? Who was it? Who was it? You guys like connive before class. So we can come up with something really good during class. Let's take our hands to the chair. We're gonna do some push-ups here. Walk your feet back with your hands on the feet of the chair. You're gonna press your fingertips into the chair. Your elbows are gonna bend by your side and you're gonna lower down a few inches and then lift up. Now we wanna make sure that we don't do this business, right? Here's ribs down and buttocks up. So we don't want that for a push-up. So to start, you start in your mountain pose, ribs are back. Hands come to the chair, keeping the ribs back. So now they're gonna start to move really up. The rib cage is moving up. I moved too far back here. We're gonna bend the elbows. They come in towards our thigh. Keep the ribs lifted. Press down through the palms, lift up. Exhale, bend the elbows. Keep the ribs on the back, the belly toning. I'm building heat. Whose idea was this? Push down through your palms, lift up. When we're pushing down, we are building strength even as we lift. We push down into the chair, our elbows bend, our ribs stay back. Now to lift up, we push down, we rise up. Notice how we're not dropping all the way down here. That's not gonna help. Won't feel good on the shoulders. Go as low as you feel like you can keep some control with your shoulders on your back. So we exhale, we bend, we bend, we bend. We feel our shoulder blades on the back. We push down, we rise up. Let's go and shake your hands out. Shake it out. We want to get out anything that was getting kind of stuck in there. Circle around and about. Do some of these flames. Just kind of rolling your hands up and down, rolling around. Can't do it wrong. Can I do it wrong? Yoga, you can't really do wrong, except if you do, if you push yourself past your edge towards injury. Let's go for a lunge. So hands on the chair, right leg is forward, left leg steps back. I got a bolster in my way. So right knee is bent, left heel is back. You can go as deep as you want. I'll move this over here. Right foot's forward, left leg is back. Heel, you can play with it lifting and lowering and lifting and lowering. Hug muscles to bum. Hug the back muscles to your bum. Maybe bend the knee and straighten. Wheel gently so you're not locking. Bend and straighten, pushing back. Bend. So now you feel your front thigh working. And straighten. One more. And then with this knee bent, softly, gently bring the back leg to meet the front. Let's go for the other side. Hands on the chair. Step the leg back, opposite leg back. Start with both knees bent. This front knee's going over towards the heel. Doesn't need to go any more forward. In fact, we don't really want it to. Back knee's bending. Inhale, straighten it. Exhale, bend it. Inhale, straighten it. Keep the spine long. And bend. One more. Hold it for a breath. Inhale. Exhale completely. When you're ready, step the right foot to meet the left. So much fun, right? Whose idea was it, all this strengthening business? Let's work our shoulders a little bit. You can sit for this if you'd like, or stand. Sit or stand, you decide which is best for you. We're going to play with the strap. So you might want to sit. Now, if your hands are tired, I just want to show this. You can press your wrists into a loop of the strap, and then you don't have to hold your hands if your hands feel tired. Make that a little shorter. And then you can push it like that. Or you can hold it like this. We're going to isometrically pull the strap apart. Pull it apart. Feel your strength. Then kind of play with doing some waves. So you see, you can do this seated. Not a problem. Just make some waves as you pull the strap taut. Yes. And then you might lift it up towards the sky. Pull it taut. So go towards your range of motion. Now it's easier to keep it wider. So if you're feeling like your shoulders need more space, widen it. Pull it taut. That's working your muscles too. When we pull the strap, get straight. Breathe in and breathe out. Let's side bend towards the right. Now pull the right hand down and the left arm up. Ooh, this is yummy. Inhale. Press down through your feet, exhale, rise up. Towards the left. Ooh, this feels so good. Nice side belly stretch. Pull the left hand down and the right arm up. Yes. Feels really good. Inhale, rise up. Release that. Give it a break. Give it a break. You can still sit or stand. We're gonna take the first, put the strap down or on the seat of your chair or your lap. Bring the right arm up, circle it up and back and around. And then the left arm up, back and around. And do this a few times. Lifts. The hand is facing center. Take it out to the side and back and around. Up. And down. Up. Back. And down. Now we're going to do it with the strap. So you're going to inhale, lift the strap up, and then pull the strap back with your right hand. So the shoulder's opening. Feel that. Feel your shoulder blade on your back when you do this. Ooh, feel that right shoulder blade. It should be coming on the back. And release. Inhale up. Pull the left arm back. Right arm is lifting. Draw the shoulder onto your back as you pull the arm bone back. Woo! Feel that. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breath is in. And breath is out. Inhale, arms rise up. Release that. Let that go. Circle the shoulders around and about. Around. Ooh, you might hear some crunchies in there. Some good old crunchies. Arms lift. Find a twist. Left arm forward, right arm back. Inhale, arms lift up, exhale other way. Lift up, maybe you add a leg. So you could do a knee or a foot. So here's a knee, here's the foot. Got that? So here's the knee, here's the foot. You could just pick one or the other. So we're gonna go twist and twist and twist and twist. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale. Twist and twist and twist. Can't get enough twists and twists. And stretch the leg, press the heel away. And release. Oof, circle those shoulders around about. We've been working them today. We've been working them. Let's take the block. You're going to press your palms into a block. Here we go with our strengthening again. Last one. Last one. Then you get a break. You're pressing your palms into the block. Notice what happens when you press your palms into the block. Your ribs are back. Your belly's toned. Keep that as the arm bones rise. Don't let the ribs jut forward as the arms rise. If they do, start again. Lower the block. So it looks like this. We don't want this. We're not looking for banana. We want ribs back, palms lift. They press into the block. They press into the block. The belly's toning. The arms are lifting. Exhale, let it go. This is a great one to do lying down. I think we've done it before. Maybe we'll do it Friday, but you'd have to remind me. All right, here we go. Arms lift, press palms into block. Lifting up, keeping ribs back. Lifting, pressing, lifting, pressing. Release that, let it go. Good back. Let's stretch the legs out. I'll turn sideways. Strap around. A foot, doesn't matter which one. You can use a loop or not. I had a loop, but I'm gonna take that. There we go. I'm talking to myself, that's okay. I'm sure you guys do it too. Press the foot into the strap. Maybe you've got some blocks in front of you to rest your leg on, or another chair to rest your leg on, or you're like me. We're gonna push the heel away, the big toe mound away. Hug the muscles to the bone. We're tall. Try not to stress out your hands. This could be helpful to not stress out the hands, to have your hands in the loop. I'll show you what I mean. Release it. Let that go. We'll do the other side with the loop so you can see what I mean. Strap around foot. Instead of holding on for dear life, you could put your wrists in like this and pull. And that way, your hands aren't stressing out. Heels pushing away, toes are spreading, spine is lifting. Maybe we bend it in and then push it away. If you're not feeling the stretch, you might lean forward a little bit. You can also have your heel down and then lean forward like this. And then up. And really nice if you have a chair that you could put your legs on for Shavasana or blocks would work too. They're not quite as high up. So now getting into our relaxation pose. Let your feet flop open. If they're down on the earth, that's fine too. Just let it go. Feel the soles of your feet on the earth or whatever they're touching. And try to release control or holding on. We just did a lot of strengthening and contracting of the muscles, some stretching as well. But we want to make sure we release. And that's part of Shavasana is really, it's a surrendering pose. It's a letting go, letting be. So you might have a mantra during your Shavasana. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. You might focus on your feet and say, inhale, let. Exhale, go. Focusing on your lower legs. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. Upper legs. Breathe in, breathe out as you let go. Feel your hips. They should feel kind of weighty on the chair. Feel them touching the chair. Breathe in, breathe out as you let go, holding in the hip area. Take your mind's eye to your belly. Maybe even put your hands at your belly. As you breathe in, no forcing, just feel the expansion. It's subtle when we're not pushing or pulling or going deep. In Shavasana, it's more of a resting breath. Exhaling out through the nose. Belly soft. And release. You might feel tingling or energy rolling through your body. Feel the pulsation of your very soft breathing in your rib cage. Gentle lift of the heart. Awareness of the shoulders. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. Few breaths focusing on the shoulder area, the whole shoulder girdle, the right shoulder blade, the left shoulder blade, and the area in the middle of both blades. Bring awareness to your upper arms. Your lower arms and your palms and fingers. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. Breathing in and breathing out, relaxing the body as a whole. Feel the sensation as you relax, the body breathing itself without you extending effort. Notice how even when you're still, you can feel life running through you. In your practice, you increased your circulation. You moved the life force of prana through you. Feel the whole body breathing. And as we end our time together, we bring our palms together in front of the heart, knowing we're all connected by the light right inside us. Breathing in and breathing out. We say namaste. Have a wonderful Wednesday. Play with your push-ups at the wall on wonderful Wednesday. I'm here for any questions you guys have.
Great job.
Thank you, Mindy. It was fabulous.
Glad you enjoyed it.
Yes, that was a good one.
Oh, you guys like it when we work on strengthening, huh? You guys like that. You guys like that stuff.
Yeah, it feels good.
Thank you, Mindy.
Thank you. So glad you're here with us. Take care, everyone.
Have a great day, everyone.
Bye-bye. Namaste.
Thank you, Mindy.